Oh, sinembe ija kwenye kirekodi.
Up gang, if you watched my last video, you knew this video was coming. Yes, you did. Yes, you did. So the previous video was about signs of knowing how you're ready to start locs. If you did not watch that video, I'll leave the link here in the description down below. So today we're going to be talking about signs you know you're not ready to start your lock journey. Because there are ways you can tell it's not yet time for you to start. First and foremost, you have little to no patience. Like when it comes to the thought of starting your hair, or rather starting your lock journey short, for you to get to like just this length, the thought of it just drives you crazy. It's not time for you to start your lock journey. As much as I'd advise you to start it short, it's a lot better. There are certain stages of the journey you may skip, you know, like the shrinkage part. You will definitely skip that when you start short. That's for certain, ask me. I did not experience that with this set, but with the previous one, yes, I did. With having little to no patience, you'll end up quitting like 4 to 5 months in. You're like, I want my hair long. Like, why isn't my hair growing? Why isn't it growing? Why are my locks not locking? You know, like, you want it instant and it's not happening. I mean, there is a way you can start it to have instant locks, which is getting instant locks, you know. But at the same time, I mean, I feel like if you want to start your lock journey, we're all different. Yes, there are those who would prefer to be like, I want to have locks in an hour. And there are those of us who would be like, I don't have mind having locks in like the next 6 months, starting with braids or twists or finger coils or comb coils, you know. But if you feel like you're just going to quit in the first few months, it's not time for you to start your locks. Point two being, you're very self-conscious about how your locks are supposed to look. In short, you're OCD. Like, you know, you just want things perfect. You don't want this madness to happen for you to look nice. You get, like, you just prefer neat and composed looks. That's why you decide to get braids, you decide to get wigs, you decide to, like, you have these protective styles, so you know you just want simple, composed and neat looks. If that's you, then you're not ready to start locks, because locks have a mind of their own. They do not listen to whatever you want to do, because I'm so sure at this very moment that there's a lock somewhere here that looks so out of place despite me trying to put it in place. So they have the mind of their own. They are very unruly. They do not listen to nobody. They may listen to you for like 5 minutes and then they decide to do what they want to do. So if you're OCD and or self-conscious, it isn't time for you to start your lock journey. Wait until you're ready to. But then also, you can challenge yourself, you know. Just try. Just know it will test you. Disclaimer, it will test you. Another point in which you know you're not ready to start your lock journey is your career. If you have those careers where you have to be in a certain way, you have to look put together. Literally 24/7, it may be a bit difficult to have locks. Maybe a bit difficult to have locks. Like, if you started your locks with my length, I will show you here, with this length. Let's say you're in media. How are you gonna sit in front of the camera looking like this? You know? Yes, you may want locks, but in this state, you will think about it twice, because you're the face of the company. If you do branding, if you do modeling, it won't work. It won't work. We're trying to get the stereotype out of making locks so unprofessional, but I can understand if your hair looks like that. Because no one will, I don't think anyone will kind of take you seriously, you know? You get. Because they'll be looking at you and be like, if you can walk out the house looking like that, how are we supposed to trust you with our brand? You get. So, if your career makes you want to always look bougie or stylish all the time, it may not be the sign for you to get locs. Probably you may want locs, but you may just have to wait a little longer till your like hair is a bit longer. Then you can start your locs easy and be able to maintain it easy, so you can be able to tie it in a ponytail, you know, like you can have it slicked. So yes, another reason you may decide or figure out you're not ready to start your locs is if you're high maintenance. Yes, hello my high maintenance babes. If you're high maintenance, it can be a bit difficult to have your locs in. Love switching it up day in, day out. Today you want to have a short bob, tomorrow you want to have a fro, in which I've seen people have fros with locs. I'm telling you, locs surprise me every day. It's possible, actually. It's possible to have a fro with locs. I saw that with one lady. She's called, what's her name? At the Lock Dawn. Yeah. Shout out to you, boo. I shall leave it here. She had a fro with her locs. I was like, okay. You know? So if you like switching it up, you know, you want to have a fro, you want to have a bob, you want to have a pixie cut, you want to have long hair the following day, you want to have, you know, like you enjoy switching it up, then it's not time for you to start your locs. Like you're still in that phase of having to want to look like different people every day. It's not time for you to start your locs yet. Last but not least is you're a product junkie. You love using all kinds of products, you know. The curl one, Tangla one. Which other products do people use? Gels, yes, people with locs still use gels. But like, you use a lot of products to maintain your loose natural hair. With locs, you don't need all that product. In fact, you will need very, very little product to maintain your locs. The most important product you will need is water, and water is easily available. You don't need to buy it. I mean, people use distilled water, so yes, you're buying it, but it's not going to be as expensive maintaining locs as maintaining loose natural hair. Because with loose natural hair, if you're braiding, you have to pay for the braids, you have to pay for the labor, you know, like there's a lot you're gonna be putting into getting that style. Yet with locs, you can get a retwist once a month, once every 2-3 months, depending on how you want to maintain your hair or how often your lactation tells you how to maintain your hair. So yes, those are the 5 pointers in which you know you're not ready to start your locs, you know. I mean, I can tell you that and you'll be like, what you mean? I can start my locs, whether I am doing all those things or not. Go you, please do. Please do what you want to do. Don't let nobody tell you nothing. Okay. So if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. Thank you so much for those of you who've been tuning in since 2020. I have slacked a lot from like 2021, 2022, but I'm trying to come back. So I'll be popping out here and there, maybe once a month. And also on the shorts, please watch my shorts. Please, thank you. If you'd like to connect with me more, you can find me on Instagram at BeeMoniRae and on Snapchat at I am Mononzuki. Peace, loving, light.